Eric Gibbons thinks there's no better place than Zilker Park to practice his freestyle frisbee moves. He's one of thousands who converge on the Great Lawn every week to relax, exercise their dogs, and play soccer and football. Eric thinks the lawn is practically perfect the way it is and does not support big changes.
As far as touching the Great Lawn, not into that.
A new poll of Austin residents found that many people agree with Eric. 83% said the Great Lawn should be left alone and did not support adding an amphitheater in this space.
The city is proposing to build a 5,000-seat amphitheater, permanent amphitheater, on the Great Lawn right here.
Daniel Weinberg says the poll, funded by Rewild Zilker Park, showed 82% of those who responded think the park should be more of a natural area for recreation.
People do not want to see permanent structures built on the Great Lawn.
The amphitheater would be the new home for the Zilker Hillside Theater, which is now located near Barton Springs Pool. Other changes include new parking garages and a land bridge that would connect the north and south sides of the park.
This vision plan was meant to enhance and restore the park.
Gregory Montez is the program manager for the Zilker Park Vision Plan. He says since the poll wasn't conducted by the city of Austin, it's hard to interpret the data.
How questions were worded, what kind of choices people had in terms of choosing an answer, all of that information we don't have.
The goal of the vision plan is to help Austin's flagship park better deal with the city's growth.
Our visitorship to the park has gone to 2.6 million a year to Zilker Park alone. So looking at the park today, is it sustainable the way it is?
According to the poll, residents support some changes, just not an amphitheater on the Great Lawn and parking garages within Zilker Park.
There are some good ideas in the plan, but these major construction projects really don't have any public support.
The Austin City Council is expected to vote on the Zilker Park Vision Plan in July. Betty Cross, CBS Austin News.